Hello friends, welcome to a new series of tutorial videos. These tutorial videos are geared specifically towards those new folks who have just started the game on Xbox One and PlayStation 4. The game just came out on July 1st for the consoles, and it's basically the same as Alpha 14 on the PC. So what I'm going to show you is the game on PC, but I will be discussing basically the only real difference between the PC version as of Alpha 14 and the Xbox and PS4 version is the control scheme, as far as using bumpers and using the D-pad and a few things like that. So the actual mechanisms of the game, the crafting, and the mechanics are all the same. So I'm going to have a series of videos. This will be the first one. This is going to go over the basic tutorial video piece where you have your tutorial quests, and we'll have a number of additional quest line tutorial videos on building, on crafting, on zombies, on survival strategies, on food, advanced stuff. So if you guys have questions or comments about the game, or you want a specific tip video, let me know in the comments below. And let's get to this. So when you first start the game, you have a choice between selecting Navigain or a random gen world. I went ahead and did Navigain because everyone I've seen so far doing a little look or a test video of the PS4 Xbox has been selecting Navigain. So Navigain is a handcrafted map. So if you go into our map area, we'll go ahead and continue past this crafting quest here in a second here. So you go into your map, and you can zoom out, and it's a fairly large map, and you can actually scroll around. If you hold the A button down on the Xbox, I can't remember which button it is on the PS4, but you can scroll the map around. It's fairly good size. Now, one huge mistake that I've been watching people do is surrounding the Navigain area, which is, let's just say it's like, here, for example. So if I go too far up this way, it'll go out of this what's called a snow biome, and it'll go into a radiation zone, which will kill you in seconds. Literally, you'll walk in and you'll be dead in 2 or 3 seconds. So if you're coming to an edge and you see it change from one biome type to another biome type really quickly, and I'll explain what biomes here are in a second, and you start taking any kind of pain, stop and move backwards immediately. It will kill you. It is harsh, and you will never get back what's in your backpack. So the way the game is set up, when you die, you lose everything on your tool belt and what's in your backpack area, so your inventory area. So here's your guy. So again, this first video is going to be about the initial starter quests and to explain what some of these things are, because I'm seeing a lot of things. People, I've got 2,000 hours into this game. I have played it to death over and over. And there are a lot of things we assume it makes sense, but when I'm seeing new players play, it doesn't make sense. So if you follow along with me, I'll explain everything in detail. So the very first quest we get is craft a stone axe. It asks you to gather plant fibers, gather wood, and gather small stones, and then craft a stone axe. So where do you get plant fibers from? Well, you get them from plants. And that may sound a little odd, but basically all of these are plants. Everything you see sticking out of the ground is a plant. It may look in a desert area, maybe really pale and tan and flimsy looking, but they're still plants. All you gotta do is punch it or hit it with any kind of weapon or club or tool, and you'll gather. And you'll see in the bottom right hand corner an icon and a number show up. That icon shows you just gathered two of something. If you look in your inventory, you can see you've got plant fibers. Now, things may be a little different on the display here, but they're very, very similar between the console and the desktop version. So here you have four plant fibers. So it asks us to gather two. We've got two already. Now, wood. Wood comes in a variety of forms. Like that building over there is constructed of wood, and we can actually get wood from it. But it takes a little while to get it. The quickest and easiest way to get wood is to look for these kind of little stick bushes. If you punch them, you get two pieces of wood off of that. You can also punch any kind of tree, and it takes a few punches, and you'll see I just got one piece of wood, I got another piece of wood. So you can gather pieces of wood that way as well. Basically, the simulation is you're pulling branches off. And now stones. Stones are usually laid on the ground here in this biome, which is the snow biome. They're just on the ground, and you can just hover over them and pick them up. And you can also find them. Let's go ahead and get a second stone here. You can also find them in what are called resource rocks. And we look over here. There's a resource rock up on this slope. And it's this large boulder. And they come in a couple different varieties. But this is basically a big rock. And you can smash your fist into it for a while. And you will, in fact, slowly gather one stone. And you can keep doing this. And you also will get, from these stones, you also get iron fragments. Or scrap iron, which we'll use for other tasks later on. Okay, so we have our first set of things. We've got our plant fibers, our wood, and our small stones. Let's go ahead and go into here. And the menu is broken up into categories. So you got your basics, you've got building blocks, and there's a page button. Let's go here so we don't have any white background here. Might be a little easier to see. There's a page button that you can go back and forth on. All the different items that you can craft. And these are all available in the console version and on the PC version. There are some additional ones on the PC. I'm currently running a bunch of mods that give me additional blocks. But basically, there's the same basic things are available. So we've got resources. We've got ammo and weapons. We've got tools and traps. Food and cooking. Medicine. Clothing. And decor and miscellaneous type blocks. So we've been asked to craft a stone axe, which is under our basics. Stone axe, craft. Now in that crafting table, let's go back there again once it finishes crafting. There's a button here where you can actually increase the number of things that you want to craft. It'll tell you how many you need to craft it and how many you have to craft it. For example, this to craft an arrow right now, I need one small stone, one piece of wood, and one feather. I have one piece of stone, four pieces of wood, but zero feathers, so I can't craft that right now. And that's per arrow. Okay, so we finished our first, and we can drag it, drop it down here. You'll notice at the bottom that it's got a number, and there's two places a number can exist. It can be in the bottom right-hand corner, and it can be in the center. The bottom right-hand corner means that's a quantity. So I've got one bottle of water. This is your starter gear on a multiplayer game. You've got one bottle of water, one can of chili, one Band-Aid, and this is a first aid bandage. There's two kinds of bandages that you can have. You can have a regular bandage, which doesn't have this plus icon on it, and you can have a first aid bandage. The difference being the one without the plus on it will just stop your blood loss if you take a blood loss attack. The one with the plus will actually restore about 30 hit points of health. And then you've got a torch, and you got a land claim block. And if you're playing on, if you're playing in a co-op environment, you can just scrap this and get some scrap iron out of it. Or if you place it on the ground, it claims an area. And let's go ahead and select it and put it down the ground. You can see this green grid around it. That green grid, anything inside that green area is protected from other players. It makes it much more difficult for other players to attack inside this. The block space will become much, much stronger. So that's how you protect your little base if you were to build such a thing. Okay? All right, so our next quest is to gather... Oh, I almost stopped. So on that icon, so we have in the center one, that means it's the quality level. So this axe has a quality level of 1, okay? And it's got a durability of 100. So as you use a tool, let's go here and hit this tree a few times and gather some wood. You see how that bar below the 1 is going down? So every time I hit something, the durability on that axe is going to decrease. So now to 89. So it's going to break when it hits 0 durability. You can repair a tool and you can just make a new one. You want to continue to make stone axes and other similar tools in order to level up your skill in that area. And we'll talk more about skills in another tutorial. All right. So the next quest is to gather or craft plant fiber clothing. So the game requires you to worry about heating and cooling, staying dry, staying warm, etc. So you need to have clothing, the proper kind of clothing for the proper kind of environment. And this is basically just teaching you, oops, I'm missing the hitbox on it. There we go. All right, so I've got enough plant fibers now. You need 35 total. So I can go to the clothing area. I see an animal up there in the corner. So it wants to craft pants, shirt, hood, gloves, and shoes. Okay, so hood, pants, shirt, and shoes. You can craft four things in the queue, and you can let them craft while you move around. So when you're crafting something that takes a little longer, you can just stick it in the queue and move around and let it craft. And then it'll be ready when it's all done. Okay, so we still need a shirt, which is still going, and then the boots. Okay. So we're ready to move on to the next phase here. Now you'll see everywhere in the world things to loot. So you want to be looting these. Everything you see, you want to loot. And we'll have another discussion all about looting later on and different things in that. All right, so we've got all of our gear now, and we want to put them on. Now, you can drag them onto the appropriate spot. For example, I can drag this hood into the headgear slot. Or I can drag the pants onto the character, and it'll auto-equip them into that proper slot. So we put your top on. Now, you can have multiple layers. So you can have a shirt. You can also have chest armor over the top of the shirt. And then you can wear a jacket over the top of that. So you have three layers of gear on in most areas. All right, so there's our next... Oh, we needed gloves. Did I not get gloves? I did not get gloves. All right, and... gloves. And once we do that, the next quest actually that'll come up, and you can see that I just got down there, it says your skill in tailoring has gone to level 2. All right, so there's the next quest coming up to put them all on. So let's get the last little piece on for our character. Boop. All right, so there's number 3 of 8 completed. All right, get the next quest. To gather wood and then craft a wooden club. So again, at the very beginning, you want to make sure you get a lot of wood and plant fibers. You'll use a lot of them really quickly. So gather those up very fast. All right, so we're going to craft a wooden club. So again, under our basics section, I'll get a little darker here for you. You want a wooden club, and you can click craft. You can also type in with your on-screen keyboard, you can type in a name in this field, and you can filter out this item. And we'll go ahead and craft that. A couple seconds. Boom! Now we have a wooden club. Okay, so again, these are low quality, but as you make them, your crafting level for each thing will go up. So if I look at an item, it'll tell me what things are involved. So to repair it, takes a small stone. It improves my construction tools is the skill involved. For wooden club, it's blunt weapons is the skill involved. Okay. And you've got your character tab. You've got your map. You've got your skills tab. You've got your quest tab, which mirrors this one up here. So now we've got our melee weapon. We could use a ranged weapon as well. So we need wood, stone, plant fibers, and feathers found in birds' nests on the ground. So we can now do that. So we want to look around for birds' nests. And the snow biome is actually one of the easier places to find birds' nests because they really kind of stand out against the snow. So what we're going to look for is a little brown thing like that. And they're in all biomes. You can find these. Select it. And we got some feathers, and we got an egg out of that. Yes. All right. So we need one more stone in order to do this. Let's go ahead and pick up a couple of these rocks off the ground. Might as well grab a few extras. I know we'll need them later on. So save time. Pick them up when you can see them. Now, there's another way to get in the stone. You'll get these outcroppings like this. They'll be around as well. And you can go up there with your stone axe and you can hit them and you can gather stone from these guys. Now these stones will also give you scrap iron at a lower rate than those resource rocks, but they'll still give you that material. Okay, so let's go ahead and craft our wooden bow. So wooden bow, again, this is under our basics section. Things that we'll be using quite a bit. So we got our bow. I'm going to go ahead and put this chili up here, put that there. I'll keep that for right now. So we have our bow. And now we need some arrows. We need at least two arrows crafted. So click on arrows. Now, if you click this button, it'll craft all that you can make. So basically, it's limited right now by the number of feathers that I have. So I hit craft, and it'll bash craft all 12 of those in one of your queues. So if you use these arrows to go up and down in quantity, you can make a whole bunch all at once. All right. So when you select your arrows, you will press one trigger to zoom, and you basically can hold down another trigger. Oops, we need to knock an arrow, and then you hold down your other trigger, and it will pull it out. When you release the trigger, it will fire the arrow and automatically re-knock a new one. Okay, so the next quest is to start a base, and we need to gather a bit of wood. So we'll gather a little bit more wood off of some small trees. We've got this little bush, and then hit this big tree. These big trees give you a ton of wood. All right, that's all the wood we need. So we need three wood frames. So again, we're going to go under our basics and wood frame, and let's go ahead and make three of those. Get that going. And I'm going to go ahead and make a new stone axe just to show you guys that your crafting skill goes up and you can keep making better and better things. So now we have a level 2 stone axe. Get rid of the old one. Don't need that anymore. All right. We have our three wood frames. Yay. And now to place them. Now you'll place I think it's the right trigger, will rotate the object. It could be the left trigger. It'll rotate. Now you won't see a rotation on the wood frame because it's symmetrical on all sides. So you won't see it rotate, but other objects will rotate, and I'll show you that here in a little bit. So you'll pull the other trigger and you'll place the frame down on the ground. And you can place them above or below, and you'll see a little outline of where it's gonna go beforehand, very similar to a lot of other games like Minecraft or whatever. And you can also hang them off of each other. Now, we'll go into it later on. There's what's called structural stability in the game. And so basically, unlike Minecraft, there's a limit to how far out I can go here with additional frames before it will collapse under its own weight. So when you're building things, you got to take that into account. And we'll have a video on building that will show you a little bit more about that. All right, so now it wants us to upgrade them. So if you look at the quest log, it'll actually tell you a little bit more about this. So place your wood frames in the world by equipping them and then using the secondary action. Okay, now upgrade them with a stone axe. You gotta have your stone axe equipped using the secondary action. So again, this will be your right trigger probably on the controller. So I'm gonna right click on this. As long as I've got wood in my inventory, it takes four hits with a stone axe. There are other tools that'll make this construction faster, but it then makes it into a reinforced block. Now, when it's not reinforced, I can still pick it up and I can put it back in my hotbar and I can put it back elsewhere. But the minute I upgrade it, it is now a solid object and I cannot change it anymore. I can damage it by left-clicking on it or using my left trigger on it. The attack action, basically, and this will destroy it. And as you can see, I'm actually getting wood back as I take this apart. So any objects in the world, for example, this building here, I can go up to it and I can start pounding on it, and I will get wood from those resources. Now, I can also upgrade these existing blocks and fix them. So, for example, here's a really badly damaged one, but I can right-click on it or right-trigger it and repair it. So I can repair one of these old buildings into a much better state. All right, so the next quest is to gather 20 more plant fibers and craft a bedroll. The bedroll is important because that is your spawn point. So wherever your bedroll is placed is where you're going to respawn when your character dies, which will happen in 7 days to die because you've got 7 days and you will die. All right, so there's our 20. So let's go ahead and we're going to craft our bedroll out of our basics tab. A few seconds to go. And I'll show you what I meant about rotations as well. So when you first start the game, you've got a grace period of a few hours in-game where zombies... Oh, there's one up there. Where zombies won't come around. But after about 5 hours of in-game time, the zombies will show up and will start pestering you. All right, we've got our bedroll now. Go ahead and click it. I'm going to select it. Now, using the left trigger, I can rotate it in different directions, and then right trigger to place it. So I can have it placed like this. Boop. Now, if I look in the map area and zoom in, I can actually see a little bed icon on the map. That'll tell me where my bed is. It'll also show up in your compass. If I turn around, it'll show me where that is. And as I go farther away from it, it'll get smaller and smaller and smaller to the point where it'll just be a tiny little icon on your bar. So that's the best way to find your way back home after a long day of looting and zombie slayage. All right, so the last step of our quest is to gather some more rocks and to make a campfire. So let's go ahead and do that really quickly. We'll go ahead here and just bash this big outcropping of rock. Oh, shiza! And then that happens. You always got to be have your mind out there for zombies. They'll show up and they will kick your ass. The snow biome has the toughest zombies. They're called the snow zombies. These lumberjacks are the toughest. They've got a ton of hit points. And with the exception of something like a feral zombie, which you won't encounter until much later in the game, they are the toughest little punks that are out there. So let's go ahead and pick up some rocks well away from that gentleman. And you typically will move much faster than zombies, other than maybe a zombie dog. Alright, so we've got that. We've got our rocks. So we're going to go ahead and craft a campfire. Let that go. And as soon as it's done, there it goes. It's done. Alright, he's lost our scent now. They have a sense memory how long they'll track you for. Alright, and we're going to left trigger to pop that, right trigger to pop it down on the ground. Boop. There we go. Campfire has been built. Now, when you complete a quest like that, you will be granted a skill or perk. Oh, this guy's still pestering us. Okay, let's get out of the way. There's no one up there too, so we gotta watch where we're going. Alright, so under the skills area, he's really gonna be a pain in the butt, isn't he? Alright, let's get over here. I'm running around, which will increase my athletic skill as well. Okay. So under the skills menu, you can see in that upper right-hand corner, points available, 1. Okay, and then you've got a point cost for each of these perks. Oh, really? You're just being a butt. I can't help it. I gotta pick up rocks. Bear! We got a bear now up there, too. Avoid bears at all costs early in the game. Bears will just own you. Alright, so skills, and we're going to look through here again, the cost and level. So this is 10 points per level. This has got 5 levels available. This archery one is 1 point per level, or it's 100 levels, and it costs 1. You're just being an obnoxious little... Oh, there's 2 of you now. Things are getting a little more hectic. There's a deer, yummy deer. They run funny as heck. You guys will get to enjoy that. All right. So for right now, you can go ahead and do something simple like archery. And I'm going to buy 1 point of that, which will increase slightly the damage I do with a bow and arrow. All right, guys, so that is it for the first tutorial video for all you new guys on the consoles. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys enjoyed this game. Do not let the graphics turn you off. This game has got a ton of gameplay to it. Like I said, I've got over 2,000 hours of gameplay in it through all the alphas it's gone through, and my aim is shite today. And when we come back, I will give you guys more tips and tricks on 7 Days to Die. Until then, it's been Wrong with the Bold. If you guys liked it, click that like button. Let me know in the comments below. Tell your friends, your family, and I'm dead. Bye-bye! Oh, they're eating me good now.